Good afternoon, friends. I would like to tell you about a very specific kind of bone marrow transplantation today. Normally, when a patient gets admitted for bone marrow transplantation, we do the initial evaluation, we decide whether this patient needs a transplant. We do a lot of tests to look at whether the patient is healthy or not. And then we admit for about 4 weeks. So patient gets into a ward, which is called as bone marrow transplant unit, and doesn't come out for 4 weeks. Stays inside his or her room, watches TV, reads, gets medicine, gets treatment. There may be some complications as well, but the patient can't come out because that's a sterile environment. This is a room where the air is filtered, the water is safe, the cleanliness is of top-notch quality. The team is special. So every patient who normally undergoes bone marrow transplantation stays in this ward called bone marrow transplant unit for about a month. And the relatives go in and come out to give him company. However, there is a particular disease called multiple myeloma. And for patients who have multiple myeloma, we can perform an autologous bone marrow transplantation without admitting them. Now, this is done in many centers abroad. This is routine treatment in US, Australia, Canada, UK. In India, probably ours is the only team which does this. So how is this done? How is it that we can perform an autologous transplantation without risking the patient's life by not admitting him in the ward? So certain criteria have to be met. The patient has to be healthy, right? Stable. The patient's family should be living within 45 minutes of the hospital. Must have a reliable family who, if there is a problem, can bring the patient into the hospital. Now, these are the prerequisites. They have to be fulfilled. Once we are sure that yes, this patient is a safe candidate for what we call as a daycare autologous transplant, that means they come every day in our ward called as daycare unit, they have blood tests, they get medicines, they get saline infusions, and they go back home in the evening. So this daycare transplantation, once the prerequisites are fulfilled, we admit the patient for 2 days and 2 days only, not the usual 1 month. In these 2 days, we give the patient chemotherapy, which is required to be given before giving the stem cells, right? So we have collected the patient's autologous stem cells beforehand, then we admit the patient for 2 days, give chemotherapy, and then give back the patient's own stem cells, because this is an autologous transplant. The patient's own stem cells are required. There is no donor. After the stem cells are infused, the patient is discharged. And he comes every day to the hospital, to our daycare unit, where our specialized, very well-trained nurses evaluate him, do the blood test, give whatever treatment is required, and send the patient back home so that he can come back the next day for his daycare visit. What we have seen is this can be safely done in the majority of patients who are healthy and have reliable relatives. But then the question is, why do it? Why put a patient's life at risk? Why not just admit for 4 weeks? We can do that. We can admit a patient and do a myeloma autologous transplant as well, but that increases the cost. The cost doubles. If you admit the patient for 4 weeks, you can all imagine how expensive it is. But in a daycare autologous transplant, the cost comes down by 50% with no risk and absolutely similar success rate. Why no risk? Because the ward is always available. If the patient has a complication, has a fever, needs to be admitted, can be admitted even at midnight. So why unnecessarily keep the patient admitted if that is not required? Why not just do a daycare autologous transplant for such patients with multiple myeloma? Give them the same success at 50% the cost. Thank you.